Hello students, I'm Dr. Olabamiji Oyebode, your facilitator for GST 202, Fundamentals of Peace Studies and Conflict Resolution. We have established in this course that conflict is natural to human existence and our relationship. So we must find ways of settling conflict. In this unit, we are going to look at peaceful methods of conflict settlement. Come with me. Peaceful methods of conflict settlement are very important to creating a peaceful environment where human beings can develop. The United Nations places considerable emphasis upon the need for nations to exist for the pursuit of global peace and to avoid conflict and to settle disputes through peaceful means wherever they occur. Article 33 of the United Nations Charter. And resolving disputes or conflict through a peaceful or amicable means in order not to endanger international peace and security is very germane. The intended learning outcome for this course is that at the end of this unit, you should be able to discuss the importance of placed by the international community upon the amicable or peaceful settlement of disputes. You should also be able to explain the means enumerated in Article 33. Of the United Nations Charter for the Peaceful Settlement of Disputes, mention the advantages of peaceful means of dispute settlement. Explain some dispute settlement concepts. Let me just tell you again that you have to go to your course material after the end of this unit to read further. We only highlight the most important issues. Conflict resolution is related to changing conflicts so that they can be conducted constructively and creatively. And so, factors to consider when looking at conflict resolution is to study and identify the issues that are critical to the conflict and even identify them critically. Address the identified issues critically through impartial fact-finding strategies. Restore a moment of harmony by assuaging the feelings of the injured party and establishing justice and fairness. The principles of conflict resolution as a peaceful means of method of conflict handling is that you should search for avenues of cooperation with the opponent on honorable terms, not coercing or not giving terrible terms. Protect the opponent's person and his resources. Reduce your demand for a minimum consistent with truth. Avoid a static condition. Launch direct action only after exhausting all other efforts to achieve an honorable settlement. Never lie, hold nothing back. Keep the opponent, public and participant informed of the movement and the actions you have been taking. Extend areas of rationality according to Schmidt 2000. Conflict management as another peaceful means of conflict settlement. This process is geared towards reducing the negative and destructive capacity of conflict through various means of measures and by working with the stakeholders, that is the parties. John Putnam, 1990, refers to it as conflict prevention. Manage and regulate the conflict so that it doesn't go beyond our hand. Conflict transformation is another peaceful means. John Paul Lettrage postulated this term and can be seen displayed in the changes created by social conflict and preceded in the deliberate intervention by third parties to create change that is needed to live in a peaceful environment. Touching on communication between parties that need to change and seek to understand cultural patterns and values of parties. Conflict suppression is another peaceful means. Use of instruments of power or force to push away the issues under the carpet or to impose a resolution is not sustainable and which the parties are not satisfied, then at least you avoid confrontation. Negotiation is a structural process of dialogue between conflicting parties about issues in which their opinions differ and they have to come together to do the negotiation in form of dialogue. There are different types of negotiation strategies. Positional negotiation bargain, or whereby you stand with your position, your needs, without bending. Principle collaborative or constructive negotiation, you give and take. Well, there's another form of a peaceful means of conflict resolution, which is an inquiry, an examination of issues in order to establish facts that may be in dispute through a calm analysis and consideration of historical facts gathered over a period of time. Manila Declaration of Peaceful Settlement of Internal Dispute in 1982 is very damning in this regard. We have good offices, we have other things that we can do to ensure there is peaceful settlement. Well, let us quickly do a self-assessment. Explain how negotiation and conflict mining can be used to handle farmers' hazardous conflict in Nigeria. You know, in the middle part of Nigeria, having hazardous farmers a conflict, how do you bring them together to negotiate, to dialogue, to address the differences and come to an amicable settlement? So it is possible. In summary, in this unit, we have examined various methods of handling conflicts in order to ensure positive outcomes. These include conflict management, resolution, transformation. Others include negotiation, inquiry, and good offices. Thank you for being here.